Talk Radio 710 WOR. The Joe Hamburg Show.
Welcome, everyone. You know, we have a lot of young people or people with young families who work here at WOR. And I always find it interesting that the women are more stressed than the men. And I see this with my daughter-in-law, with my daughter. The guys, I mean, they're stressed. These are stressful times. But the women are more stressed. And then a new national survey released by More Magazine shows that sacrificing your personal life so you can climb the ladder, whether it's corporate or whatever, media, for a lot of women today, 43% may not be worth the journey. And Jennifer Braunschweiger, More Magazine deputy editor, knows the whole story here. And I'm going to let her tell you what they found out in their Women in Workplace survey, which they did with the polling company, the Woman Trend, November issue of More Magazine. Jennifer, were you surprised?
Yes, we were very surprised. We talked to 500 women across the country about their attitudes toward work and thought that we would ask them about ambition. And as you said, 43% of them describe themselves as less ambitious now than they were 10 years ago. We found that very surprising.
And a lot of these women had college degrees, were professional, had an income ranging between $60,000 and $75,000, and yet they were backing away from top corporate work.
Yes, these are all women who are currently employed in professional jobs. 49% of them were managers. So these were people who had gotten to a certain level of professional accomplishment and just looked around and decided it wasn't worth it. In fact, we hear that from women all the time. They say, it's just not worth it.
But as you say, More Magazine's chief editor, Jane Seymour, really is concerned about this, because moving backwards when it's tough enough to get women right up there is not a good trend.
We would love to see more women represented in top positions on boards, in CEO spots, and women have, in order to make those numbers go up, women have to want to get there. And so it is dismaying to hear that they don't necessarily want to get there. But a lot of them also agreed with the statement that a woman who wants to have a career and a life is ambitious in a different way. And that suggests that there may be a shift in ambition going on, a sort of redefinition of what success means. Maybe success doesn't have to be the corner office. Maybe the success is a great career you love and a satisfying personal and family life.
But how do you really combine that? Because great careers take tremendous amounts of time and a lot of personal sacrifice no matter what you do.
Yes, absolutely. You know, only 11% of the women told us that they wanted to work less. This isn't about minimizing the hours spent at the office. Rather, it's about having more control over how and where you work and when. And control in many ways comes down to flexibility. So
that's interesting. So it isn't
right
that they're telling you, hey, we've had it, we want to stay home. They're saying, we don't mind working, we don't mind putting in the hours, but we don't want to be under the gun.
Exactly. We don't want to be under the gun, or we want to be the judge of whether we can make it to a 4 o'clock dance recital, knowing that, in fact, we had already gotten the work done. You know, do we have to be in our seats at 4 o'clock just because it's 4 o'clock, or can we be judged on our results and on the quality of the work we do rather than exactly the moments that we're sitting in the chair?
All part of a More Magazine, are women less ambitious than they were 10 years ago? So, Jennifer, what were some of the areas that women thought they could accommodate a better life along with satisfying work?
Well, we looked for jobs where women had more control, and we sort of analyzed 70 different professions, different careers, to try to find the ones that allowed women a chance to both make a fair amount of money, have some control over what they were doing and yet also be in growing careers. And we ranked 10 jobs, and we found that the most flexible job, or the one that combined these attributes, was personal financial advisor.
That's one, right?
Yes.
Okay. And what are some others?
Pharmacist, web professional, physical or occupational therapist, a medical professional like a nurse or a dental hygienist, and we go on from there.
And those jobs, though, are very demanding. And is it just that when you're in hardcore corporate America, there's someone really right on top of you with the whip?
Those are jobs where the flexibility is baked in, where there's a lot of opportunity perhaps for entrepreneurship, so there's a chance to start your own business and make your own rules. We hear a lot of women are interested in starting a business, or where for instance, in the case of the web, where clients want a job to come in on time and on budget, but they don't really care when or how it gets, when you're doing the work.
So they want their own terms. And yet I was interested in reading that even though a large percentage of women value workplace flexibility, a third says it's career suicide to ask for more flexibility.
Yes, isn't that interesting? 33% of them agree with the statement that it's career suicide to ask for it, but 92% of them want it anyway. And I think that's really a statement on how complicated our lives have become. And as you said, how difficult it is to have a demanding career and yet also have a marriage, have me time, have time for your kids, take care of elderly parents. We have so many demands right now that the sacrifice seems worth it.
How did women seem to feel about childcare, children?
Well, that was another very surprising thing we found, was that when asked the question whether they wanted more time or more money, in fact, it was women without children who more wanted time.
That is unbelievable, right?
Yes. We really expected them to say that it was childcare, and in fact, that did not turn out to be the case. Women did not identify household demands and childcare as having held them back in their careers, and when we asked them what they would do with more flexibility, they didn't say they would spend their time with their kids. They said they wanted more me time. I think maybe what is happening here is that women, through long, difficult practice, are figuring out how to have jobs and kids, but they're leaving themselves out of the mix.
Well, don't you think, too, that with housing and the world in a little disarray, that people are commuting hours away? If your job is in a big city like Manhattan or downtown Chicago, here, so many people can't afford to live here, especially with families, that they end up commuting 2-4 hours a day, and that has to add to the enormous stress.
Yes, I think that's completely true. Commuting is certainly an issue. And in fact, the workplace has gotten very demanding. I think the recession, those of us who are lucky enough to still have our jobs, and we're very, very grateful, but where everyone really across the board, everyone I talk to says that they are expected to do more with less at the office.
Yeah, I find that really interesting, because when we look at it and analyze it, and we're interested in your calls at 1-800-321-8828, 1-800-321-8828, these women are not telling you, we want to be stay-at-home mommies or we want to stay home. They're saying, we want some freedom, some control. We're willing to pay the hour's price, but we want to feel we're in charge.
Yes, that's right.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say we do not hear from them that they want to work less. Women want to work and they want to be taken seriously at work. But in order to get everything done, they need a measure of control over how they're working.
And it also was interesting that a lot of women are not complaining about not having enough household or child care help, that it hasn't held them back.
That's true. This is not an indictment of men in any way. The women are not saying that they need their partners to shoulder the burden. That was not what we were hearing from people.
So the big question is, are you less ambitious? Are your daughters less ambitious than they were 10 years ago? How do you see your life? Of course, these are difficult times, so that has to have entered a little bit in it. But women have been piling in the workplace since the 70s, and maybe less ambitious, a handful more. But what is the answer? I thank you so much for your time. I look forward to talking to you again. A really interesting survey. All in More Magazine. I'm Joan Hamburg, 1-800-321-8828. Jennifer, again, thanks. I'm Joan Hamburg. We'll talk right after this. 1-800-321-8828. 1-800-321-8828.
Hi, it's Michael Smith Radio, 710 WOR.
Officially opened at 1-800-321-8828. It's so interesting for us to hear that most women do not want their boss's job. They don't want to stop working, but they don't want that job. They are less ambitious than they were 10 years ago. And what I found absolutely fascinating is that it's not just women with children. It's single women who don't care about that corner office. In fact, 68% of women without children would rather have more free time than make more money at work. And more of those than those with children, don't you think? Isn't that interesting? So they're not throwing in the towel, all these women. They want to work, but they're just redefining ambition. I find that so interesting because when I was coming of age, I didn't have a life plan that said, oh my gosh, when I'm 25, I'm going to be this. When I'm 30, I'm going to be that. It just kept happening because many women of my generation were not working unless they really had to economically. And even those, many were wives and mothers. So it's all changed. It is literally all changed. And yet my kids, when I would go up to Barnet, where I went to school, and I'd go to a different things and events, the young girls I would talk to were to the opposite of me. I'm going to be this at 25, this at 30, that at 35. And now it's all swinging back again. So it's not that they don't want to work. And in a way, women's leaders are really upset because they're saying, we don't have enough women in the top. We don't have enough women in the boardrooms. And all of a sudden, we're seeing this backslide of women who want it easier. They want more flexibility. They want more time. It's a lot to think about. We have a whole new crop of baby girls coming along, too. It's 5 minutes before 2. Lou Dobbs at 2 after this. Stay tuned.